Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in PA.
If you did the previous exercise, go and open the file 00_011_DIAB where you save it. Or you can go and download this file from the website, or you can just sit down and watch. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as button. Save the drawing as 00_012_DIAB and click the save button. This will save the drawing in your name so that any work that you do in this exercise doesn't affect the previous work. Select all this furniture and hit the delete key. Now copy this bed. Select the bed and go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. Copy this bed into the master bedroom. Hold down your shift key if your auto mode is on to deactivate it temporarily. Place the bed here. Press escape. Now select the bed and hold down your shift key and type number one key on your keyboard. This will bring the property palette. So move down and look for the scale of the bed. As you can see, the X scale factor is -1, the Y scale factor is 1, the Z scale factor is 1. So first let's change the X scale factor from -1 to 1. Let's see how the block will display. Delete the positive sign and click to the other input. You see the bed now flip in the right direction. Let's go to the drawing area and try to figure out the size of the bed. Use the move tool to move it out of this wall a little bit. Click down, use the distance command and measure the distance of the bed. The bed is 5 feet. We want this bed to be 7 feet. So, select the bed and click into this area. Type 7/5. Press enter. Back to the drawing. Go to the Home tab, Utility panel, and click this down arrow. Select the measure command. Measure the bed. The bed is now 7 feet. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the bed and go to the Home tab, Modify panel. Select the rotate command. Click at the midpoint of the bed and rotate the bed into this direction. Now use the move command by selecting the bed. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the move command. Use the midpoint object snap to position the bed. Snap the bed into this area, then select it again. Go to the move command, click in this area and move to the left. Type 6 inches and press enter. The bed moves 6 inches away from the wall. Select this other bed and use the copy command. Click anywhere for the base point and copy the bed into this room. Again, hold down your shift key if the auto mode is disturbing you. Click to place the bed. Press escape. Now select the bed. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the mirror command. Use the midpoint object snap and click. Move into the opposite direction and click. Select the yes option. Select the bed and use the move command. Move the bed towards the top of this building. Use the perpendicular object snap and place the bed. Select this toilet and use the copy command. Copy this toilet from this point and hold down your shift key and place it into this point. Hold down the shift key again and place another one into this point. Again, the precision and the rotation is not important, just to indicate that this is a toilet or whatever. So go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and select the Make Current button. Select the stair to make it the current layer. Now go to the Home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Draw a line from the midpoint of this line and draw it past this point. Press escape. Start the line command again. Draw a line from the midpoint of this line and hover the mouse cursor from this point and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the line command. Hold down your shift key, right click and select mid between two points. Use this as the first midpoint and move your mouse cursor into this area and click. Now draw the line from that point and hover the mouse cursor here and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M for multiple option and press enter. If your radius is not 0 inches distance, use the radius option and change the radius to 0 inches distance. Select this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down the control key and type number 2 on your keyboard to bring the design center. Double click EN, double click design center, double click house design, double click block and look for oval top and move it into the drawing area. Bathtub, move it into the drawing area. Close the dialog box. Select this block and move it to the plumbing layer. This to the plumbing layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this bathtub and move it into the master toilet. Place it here and move this zinc. Turn off the auto mode and place the zinc into this area. Select it and move it precisely. It needs to be inside the bathroom completely. Yeah, I'm not going to waste my time to position this object precisely because this is just for illustration. Again, I'm going to bring another door to fix door on this object area. So click, hold down the control key and click number 2 to bring the design center and select this before door, move it into the drawing area. Close the design center, select this door and copy it into this location. Press escape. Now select the door and use the rotate command. At the point specifying base point prompt, use the endpoint object map to pick this base point and turn on the auto mode if it's not on. Move the mouse cursor until the door orients like mine and click. Select this door and move it to the wardrobe layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this door and delete it. Go to the view control and click the top, custom model view, first floor plan. Alright, in this tutorial you learn more of the command that you have already used. You will learn how to change the size of the block with the properties palette. In the next tutorial, we will start to place text in our drawing to label the drawing. If you find this tutorial interesting, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you want any specific tutorial or you have any comment or you have a suggestion, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along in this series or you want any other tutorial from my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.